FY19. Balraj Joshi, the chairman and managing director of NHPC, joins us. Mr. Joshi, good morning. Thanks for joining us. You know, this time, I mean, I was just going through your standalone numbers. Your revenues have fallen 17%, but your margins were strong. I guess the generation expenses for you have fallen. Can you give us a sense of what FY19 looks like? What would the capex plans for the company be? And, you know, an update on various projects as well.
Well, thank you very much. As you know that this year the monsoon has not been very good for us, and two of our plants also had to be shut down. That is in West Bengal, Teesta Load M3 and 4, because of Gorkha Janmukti Morcha agitation, whereby we lost about 400 million units of generation. And despite that, I would say that in the Q4, if you see, we have done reasonably well, wherein we have earned a profit of about 185 crores as against 157 crores last year. And the reason for that has been the securitization of our dues from BYPL. And as far as the 18-19 is concerned, definitely IMD has already said that the monsoon is going to be good this time. And I would just like to say here that monsoon good and excessive monsoon, they are two different terms. And excessive monsoon sometimes doesn't really result in very good profits for us, because it carries a lot of silt. And then we have to shut down the plants for more maintenance, as well as for flushing of the silt from the reservoirs. So I would expect that the way these predictions are, we are going to have a reasonably good profit this time also. And added to that would be another achievement which we have just made. You must have seen that one of our plants, 330 megawatt Kishanganga plant, it was dedicated to nation at the hands of the Prime Minister on 19th, and we expect that our generation now is certainly going to improve, and you will see much better results in 18-19.
Mr. Joshi, good morning. Could you give us some numbers then for FY19 on the back of a normal monsoon? If that progresses, what will the generation look like? Any guidance on that? And even on your profits, when you say it should be a good year, what should we expect?
Well, you see, we have this time generated about 22,923 million units, which is slightly shorter than the target which we had kept for ourselves. And but coming to the 18-19, the target is about 25,000 million units. And I hope with the Kishanganga going full steam ahead now, we would be able to achieve that kind of figure.
Okay, so you spoke about Kishanganga.
That's about 25,000 million units, yeah.
Yeah, you spoke about Kishanganga going full stream, but what about Parvati 2? There was a delay that took place over there. What's the latest, and when can we expect commercialization?
Well, as you know, Parvati 2, we have a problem in the tunnel, wherein one of our tunnel boring machines got stuck, and we are crawling ahead in the tunnel, and I would not say that we will be able to put it full steam, as I said, for Kishanganga in the coming year. But there's a possibility that we can divert the water off some nalas, and we can commission at least 2 units of Parvati also this year.
Okay, what's the...
It will be around 400 megawatt additional.
Okay. Yeah. What's the annual capex guidance for FY19?
Well, capex we have kept at about 3,300 crores, out of which our subsidiaries will be contributing 342 crores. And of course, it depends much of our capex plans actually are based on Subansiri projects, and we are waiting for the outcome of Subansiri, which is being heard by NGT, as you know. And the judgment has been reserved for that project. We are expecting that soon it will be delivered in our favor, and we shall be able to meet the capex plans as laid out.
Okay, well, there's some news coming in from ICICI Bank. They denied having asked Chanda Kochar to go on leave. It seems like whatever has happened, whether she was asked or whether she's gone on leave herself, it has taken place. And, you know, there was a lot of pressure coming in from institutional investors as well to sort of do that inquiry by the board. It did not happen up until now, but now it has been initiated. But ICICI Bank coming out with the clarification saying that they have not asked Chanda Kochar to go on leave. It is, in fact, annual leave which was planned well in advance.
And they've also denied that they have appointed any search committee to find her successor. So that denial too coming in from ICICI Bank. But I guess the street just wants this clarity to be over, this uncertainty. Stock is higher in trade today.
Okay, yeah, I know. A lot of shareholders would be happier if the board had, you know, sort of asked her to go on leave, and if this whole, if the board had some spine, basically, to go ahead with this issue on their own. But, well, the bank has denied that. Nevertheless, the stock is actually coming off a tad bit now, still up in the green, up about 3-odd%. But Mr. Joshi, you know, thank you so much for joining us. You've given us an update on all of your projects. Thank you for waiting by as well. Just one final question on hydro policy, because, you know, a lot of people believe that the growth potential with these hydropower plants is very high because of the untapped water energy potential in India. Wanted to understand from you, what kind of growth do you see for the company? I was asking you about the hydro policy. You know, what kind of growth do you see for hydropower plants?
Well, as you know, hydro policy is in the discussion at various stakeholders are giving their inputs, and I think the government is now ready with the policy, and it is in the final shapes. We have been constantly saying that, you know, hydro projects are not just projects for a commodity, but they have been instrumental in developing the areas, far-flung areas for country. And when we say that we have to integrate particularly the northeastern part of the country, hydro projects are basically a vehicle for integration of these areas. And these are the sentiments and these are the inputs which we have given for the hydro policy. We say that the cost of infrastructure, for example, should not be loaded onto the power. And similarly the flood moderation, similarly the flood moderation aspect should not be loaded. Well, I'm not able to get you very clearly, ma'am.
Mr. Joshi, we've got you in a bit of a scratchy line, so we leave that conversation there. Thank you very much for joining in.